song is a very peculiar quality. It's a quality that you develop within the body. But there's also an active part to it, the skill of releasing. I suppose it's also the skill of being able to tense yourself up and release. There is a duality, the yin and yang to everything, and the whole focus of Taoist philosophy particularly is this interplay between yin and yang. And it's not yin or yang or yin, it's yin yang. And the proportions of each quality or each polarity that exist in a given moment, which allows you to create and affect change. So from a Sungong perspective, if you're looking at it from the health side of things, it's working out where you are holding yourself tight, tense and rigid within your body and learning to release and let go. So you become aware of the joints and how they're tight, closed, and then release and expand. You become aware of the spine and how you're holding yourself tight and rigid, and then release. So the tightness, the rigidness, the strain is Li, or stupid force. Li in itself is not actually stupid force. Li, I believe, means force. So Li can apply to the force that you apply through a jin, I think. Not being able to speak Mandarin, I don't want to actually tell Chinese people how to speak their own language, because that would be stupid. But the way I understand it is that we hold ourselves tight, tense and rigid in order to maintain structures within our bodies, instead of releasing, relaxing and expanding and allowing the structure to grow from that. But so the tension in the joints, the tension in the skin, the tension in the bones, all that strain is stupidly where we're holding that force where we don't need to. Sung is the ability of, or the quality you develop within your body of release, relaxation. Relaxation is not quite the right term. Release is definitely a good term to use, but it's fluidity, I suppose, more than anything else, so that you can flow, you can move, and you're not holding yourself tight. A good example of when you won't be sung is in a high space, look down the ladder, and as you go to step on the ladder, if you're not used to doing that, you can feel the tension in your body. You become aware of it. On some level, you're definitely aware of it. It could be a feeling that you're going to fall, and that is the locking up. The skill of song is to realize that that's what you've done, and then release, relax, so that you can then step round and move fluidly without resistance. So there are so many elements to Sunglong. I mean, it might just look on an outward appearance that you're just swinging your arms about, but to actually get your arms to switch off is quite a difficult thing to do. To actually get a rotation through your body around the spine using the waist rather than just from the shoulders or just from the arms. So we can just swing our arms like this, but it's the arms that are doing it. Then we can sort of like twist through the body, and you see my shoulders and my waist are not connecting. Or I can use my waist, and now my waist is commanding the movement and there's more power. And then from my center, I'm drawing power from the legs and I'm allowing myself to move around the center and I'm relaxing down through the spine. So it becomes quite in depth. And that's the same with all the Qigong, really. It's not just waving your arms about, not just following a particular pattern of movement. It's finding the integration, finding the connection through the body. And not just the physical connection. So there is a physical connection with this movement down through into the leg, off that foot, comes up over and down, which allows me to turn my waist. I've also got this hip now going forward. I can then draw that hip back square and sit down on that side. So I'm creating this kind of like piston action through the legs, which you can do naturally, but to actually become aware of it and start to do it consciously, it's quite a fun game, because it's sort of like, you just end up wagging the tailbone about if you're not watching what you're doing, because it's not that. It's dropping in, sitting down, hip forward. And then the hip rotates back, it pulls back. But at the same time, I have to release up through this leg, the left leg, the opposite side, and then sink down through the right leg. And then again, come back. So all these things you are working on as you're doing the Sunglong. So it's not, if you're just standing there, this is nice, you're sort of crushing down through your structure. you're not involved, you're not here, you're not being present. And that doesn't help you when you really want to start to get your head around what it is you're trying to do with the song. On a very basic level, you're opening the body up, opening the joints, opening the vertebrae, straightening the back, lifting the head, suspending the head, opening the neck, and all of that, you end up standing to attention and you lock yourself up. So then when you've got there, you need to relax, release. Allow yourself to breathe. Allow yourself to breathe. Allow yourself to release and relax, let the mind sink down. Now, beginning Wu Qi, connect to the ground, softening feet, ankles, knees, hips, tailbone drops, chin tucks, head suspended. So we have our alignments through the body. And we're breathing into the belly, softening the rib cage, the diaphragm, and the abdomen. Allow ourselves to hang off the skeleton so the bones are floating upright, head suspended to create a feeling of lightness. Gravity flowing down through the legs, tailboning drops. Tailboning? Tailbone drops. So just the very act of standing still, there's a lot of components to it. But it should be light, it should be relaxed, harmonious. You're not leaning forward or back, side to side. You're looking for any twisting or talking through the body. Letting it go.